So we're going to go ahead and make the noughts and crosses or tic-tac-toe game in Python. And initially what we're going to do is we're going to start off with making the board. Now you could do this graphically, but an easier way to do it is using a list. So what we can do here is we've got an empty list, and what you can print out the three different rows. Depending on if there's an X or a zero in there, or a cross in there. So we're going to start by breaking this down a bit, and we're going to do just player one's game at the moment. So we're going to put an input in, and we're going to make it an integer input. And I'll explain why in a bit. So which position do X in. So we'll assume that the person knows that the board is named 1 to 9. So each position, there's 9 positions in a noughts and crosses board, first one being 1, the last one being 9. So we will get the user to type in either 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, depending on where they want to move. So what we need to do now is check on the board if somebody is in that space or not, or if it's blank. So what we can do is we can do if row, now that's the name of our list, and we're going to say move minus 1 is equal to nothing. Okay. Now what this means is we're saying if the row is this number here, so move, this is the number the user's inputting, and this relates to an index number. Okay, so in a list, the first position, the first thing in a list is always called 0, second is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way up to 8. Okay, now we've got 9 entries in our list, but the first entry is numbered 0, so 0 to 8, which gives us 9 entries. Remembering 0 is a number. Now the user is not going to be typing in 0 to go into position 1, they're going to be typing in 1. So we need to minus 1 to check for the correct index number. Okay, so if they type in position 1, it's actually going to be looking in position 0, which is here. So that's why we need the minus 1. So we're saying if there's an empty space, what we want to do is we want to say whatever is in that position in our list at row minus 1, move minus 1 becomes X, okay, because this will be the X move. All right, so if there's a space in there, instead of being a space, it will now become an X. Okay, so we can check if that works, and we can do this by printing out the board. Okay, so to print out the board, we essentially need to print out the different rows in our list. So what we can do is we can do something like that. I'm trying to unindent those because they've come in indented from my copy. So what we're saying here is we want to print our list called row. We want to print position 0, 1 and 2, but not including 3. Okay, that's the number it's going up to. Then underneath, we want to print positions 3, 4, 5, but not 6, and so on. The last one, 6, colon, nothing, is 6 to the end of the list. Okay, so if we go ahead and run this, we should be able to put in a X somewhere, so position 2. Okay, so that's the first stage of our board setup. What we need to now do is add a loop, so it will keep asking us. Okay.